Thank you. a way of certifying experience, taking photographs is also a way of refusing it. By limiting experience to a search for the photogenic, by converting experience into an image, a souvenir. Travel becomes a strategy for accumulating photographs. The very activity of taking pictures is soothing and assuages general feelings of disorientation that are likely to be exacerbated by travel. People robbed of their past seem to make the most fervent picture takers, at home and abroad. Everyone who lives in an industrialized society is obliged gradually to give up the past, but in certain countries, such as the United States and Japan, the break with the past has been particularly traumatic. In the early 1970s, the fable of the brash American tourist of the 1950s and 60s, rich with dollars and babbitry, was replaced by the mystery of the group-minded Japanese tourist, newly released from his island prison by the miracle of overvalued yen, who is generally armed with two cameras, one on each hip. Hi guys, welcome back. So I'm here to talk about my trip to Vietnam. It was so much fun. We got to stay in this really nice resort hotel. It was beautiful. We got to see like the countryside and stuff. And oh my gosh, have you like tried their coffee? Like honestly, Ho Chi Minh City is like basically the capital of cafes. There's so much to do and the food is so cheap, and honestly I could recommend it to anyone that they should totally go to Vietnam and have a ton of fun. Everyone there was super friendly. We got led by our tour guide Quan, and he was like super sweet, and